What if our phones turned out to be racist, misogynistic, homophobic pricks? Oh right, they have been all that. Artificial intelligence such as Siri and Alexa are great for convenience and offer a number of benefits, but they also have a lot of flaws, and discrimination is one of them. Google, Microsoft, and Facebook have all admitted to this, and they are trying to perfect this tech so we can have more ethical, humane AI in our lives. But if the data we input into this system comes from a society filled with biases, how can we develop an unbiased AI? Artificial intelligence has been around for more than 60 years now. The term was first coined in 1956 by computer scientist John McCarthy. Research centers across the US then started exploring the creation of systems that could efficiently solve problems and that could learn by themselves. Machine learning algorithms have been developed to analyze data, learn from it, then make predictions and decisions based on those insights. AI started in programs used to solve general common sense scenarios, mathematical problems, and geometrical theorems. It was also used to master checkers. Today, we see it in search engines, face recognition, social media, smartphones, cars, and the virtual assistants we put inside our homes.
Hi, what can I do for you?
And while it can determine anything from stock prices to medical diagnoses, it can still struggle telling apart a knee from a face. Really, Facebook has asked users to tag their knees thinking they were people's faces. Truth is, computer scientists have much bigger challenges than teaching these systems to process data. You see, artificial intelligence is just like a child, meaning they'll learn from our behavior. And the more data you feed into a machine learning algorithm, the smarter it gets. Unfortunately, most of the data we're feeding these algorithms comes from Silicon Valley. And as we know, they have a lot of issues with diversity. Companies such as Facebook, Google, IBM, and Microsoft have realized that their algorithms are filled with biases. So the fault here is with the people who input the data, not the AI algorithms themselves. Think about it this way. If you're using AI to hire someone, you feed it data of successful candidates you've hired in the past. The AI will then recommend new candidates based on that dataset. There's just one problem. If all your past hires are mostly white men from Ivy League schools, then the AI will only recommend candidates that meet that criteria. Because it's all it knows. And this isn't something I just made up. We've seen this behavior play out time and time again. Siri, for starters, has provided homophobic answers to questions relating to LGBTQ+ topics. It's also offered offensive replies to the question, "What is an Indian?" And it's been under fire for how it responds to sexual harassment remarks. Then there's facial recognition, one of the best known applications of AI, which has proven to single out people of color because they're disproportionately represented in mugshot databases. Beauty software has also favored white candidates in a contest in which more than 6,000 people submitted their pictures to have their attractiveness evaluated. Out of the 44 winners, only one was dark-skinned. Another AI thought names such as Emily and Matt were more pleasant than names such as Jamal and Ebony. Law enforcement in Florida used software to predict future criminals, just like Minority Report, except this algorithm was found to disproportionately target black defendants and wrongly label them as future criminals at almost twice the rate as white defendants. In some cases, the algorithm got it wrong. Low-ranking white defendants ended up committing more crime. Then there are things like Google's algorithm, which tagged black people as gorillas, Microsoft's lovable chatbot named Tay, who turned into a Nazi in just 1 week, and online ads that have been found to hide high-paying jobs from women. And the list just goes on and on. What are we doing to fix this problem? And is there even a solution? Erasing bias from databases, it's complicated, especially when there's no type of regulation or standard governing the data used to train machine learning algorithms. So I spoke to Shiv Sain, founder of Savvy Matters and an expert in AI, to get some insight on what Silicon Valley is doing to create a more humane and ethical AI.
There needs to be many more ethicists and thinkers and psychologists at the senior levels in these companies so that every time decisions are being made, it is being looked at not just through a technology lens or a business lens or, you know, servicing a specific customer need lens, but also through the psychology and the ethical implications.
Right now, every tech firm is looking for ways to diversify its data on customers and users. But they also need to make sure they're being transparent with this data and how they gather it. Because as long as humans are involved, you can't really get the bias out. Yet, these companies have all invested heavily in having balanced data sets. A notable effort in this regard is the partnership on artificial intelligence between Facebook, Amazon, Google, IBM, and Microsoft. This partnership aims to address the ethical issues of AI and make sure that a more diverse set of eyes are looking at AI before it reaches the public. Then there's the initiative from Elon Musk, OpenAI, which aims at making AI more transparent, expand access to it, and prevent it from becoming a tool to do evil things.
Everyone's learning, and I think that's probably my biggest message, where we need to be patient, we need to let the technology mature, and we need the companies behind the technologies to have large enough data pools.
Best case scenario, we develop an AI that's more of an enhancement and not a replacement for human beings. Worst case scenario, AI takes over most of our jobs and rules humanity, much like the late Stephen Hawking theorized. Only this time, the AI is a bigot. But it all depends on us. I don't mean just tech companies. We, as a society, a human species, need to be more responsible for what we teach our robots, just like we do with our kids. So choose love and not hate. Hey y'all, thank you so much for watching ContECHtual. If you enjoyed watching this as much as we did making it, then please make sure to like and subscribe, and tune in next Thursday to watch a new episode. Also, we would love to hear from you. So if you have any topic ideas or just want to chat, make sure to comment in the section below or message us. See you next time.